So, good morning, all of you. I hope I'm audible and visible to everyone. Please give me a thumbs up if my audio and video is clear to all of you. So, welcome to the next session of Dermatology on Let's Crack Neet PG. Now, I'm Dr. Cheshita Agarwal, your Dermatology Educator on An Academy. Today, I will take care of a very, very important topic, and that is previous year MCQs in Dermatology. Please remember that the key to success to clear any exam is the previous year MCQs. I request all my students to get through the 10 years of previous year MCQs. Today I have planned to give you some of these questions from the previous year examinations, for example, NBE pattern examination, or from the exams like INICT, etc., FMG also. So I've tried to club all the FMG or NBE pattern examination questions together. Now, before going ahead, I just want to tell you what is An Academy. This is the best online platform for the preparation of NEET PG. Now, how to download? Just search An Academy Learning App on the App Store. Try to install it. Now, why An Academy is the best online platform for the preparation of NEET PG? Because it gives you the access or the live interaction with the educators. Nobody else, no other online platform is giving you this benefit of live interaction with your educators. So it is like sitting at your home and having a direct one-to-one interaction with your educator. So that is the best part of An Academy. Now, this month we have launched very, very good courses which will be helpful for you for your preparation. For example, we have started a batch course which is targeting FMGE batches, targeting next pattern, and a newer batch has been started which is targeting NEET PT examination. I request all my students to get through the subscription using my referral code. Please use my referral code CHESHITA10 to get the subscription. Okay? So I hope everyone understood what I'm trying to tell. The next is the 15-day fortnightly the test series which is called as An Academy Combat. It's time for the second of the An Academy Combat session. The topics of the second An Academy Combat is pharmacology, pathology, forensic medicine, and anesthesiology. Now, in this grand test or An Academy Combat, you will have 45 questions which you have to finish over a period of 60 minutes. Please remember, top 3 educators will receive free An Academy subscriptions, and the remaining up till the rank 50 will get the Amazon vouchers, depending upon the rank, the amount of the vouchers depend. Now, this is absolutely free. So I want everyone to get enrolled, but you need a referral code to unlock the free session. And the referral code is written here, that is CHESHITA10. So I request all the students to use the referral code and to get yourself enrolled. Now, lastly, we have two subscriptions. One is Plus and one is Iconic. The Iconic gives you the access of An Academy and Prep Ladder for total 1 year. So if you are giving next 2022 exam, this is the best thing which you can have. If you use my referral code, that is CHESHITA10, you can have the same thing in 49,500. For Plus, which is best for your NEET PG 2021 preparation, I will request you to get a 1 month subscription, which is of 5,000. Using my referral code will make it 4,500. So please get through one of these subscriptions, which is very, very useful for your preparation. Starting with the first question of the today's session. Good morning, Dr. Kostu. Please do the first question of the today's session. Start with the first question. So a patient was treated with steroids for psoriasis. On stopping the treatment, he developed fever, malaise. Lesions are seen as the image below. What is the probable diagnosis? So can you answer this question, Dr. Kostu? Very nice, very nice. The correct answer of this question is acute generalized pustular psoriasis. So when a patient is treated with steroids for the psoriasis, please remember psoriasis, we do not use steroids. But sometimes because of some ill treatment by say the Bengali Babas or some other places, these patients get treated with steroids. Whenever they're given steroids for psoriasis, the well-defined nature of the plaque are lost and they become confluent or larger in size, involving more than 90% of the body surface area, which is called as erythroderma. Or they can also form multiple pustular lesions, which can combine together to form a large lake of pus. This is called as pustular psoriasis. Understood, all of you? So this is very, very important. And yes, Kostub, you're right. This condition, when it is associated with constitutional symptoms, it is called as von Jumbusch disease. So very nice. I think you understood. Moving to the next question. All of the following infections are present with maculopapular rash except. So this is a repeat question. This is a question from AIIMS exam 2019 and 20. So November 2019 and May 2020 AIIMS paper. All of the following infections present with maculopapular rash except. Very nice. So this is a repeat question. I've already discussed this. Very nice, Dr. Kostub. Shingles, which is another name for herpes zoster. It presents with grouped vesicular lesion. It do not present with maculopapular rash. Very nice. Can you answer this question for me, Dr. Kostu? The next interesting question, flaccid bullae, oral lesions, picture given below, acantholytic cells on Zang smear, what is the probable diagnosis? Good. The correct answer here is option number 1. So pemphigus vulgaris is the correct answer. Now if you remember, I have told you flaccid bullae means intraepidermal. Intraepidermal, two type, pemphigus vulgaris, pemphigus foliaceus. Next thing is oral cavity, which is present or involved in the patients of pemphigus vulgaris, but it is not involved in the patients of pemphigus foliaceus. So please remember this trick. This is very important to solve the questions. Moving to next question, which of the following is the true associations? This is again a repeat question. Very nice, Dr. Kostub, you are absolutely right. Which of the following is the true association? Can anybody answer this question for me? Very nice, Dr. Kostu. Any other student want to answer this question? Very nice. So please remember the true association is psoriasis with metabolic syndrome. This is also a repeat question from AIIMS, as well as this was the question in JIPMER also. The true associations of psoriasis and metabolic syndrome, which means that patient of psoriasis have an increased risk of metabolic syndrome, which includes obesity, hypertension, it includes hyperlipidemias. even diabetes mellitus, and they are at increased risk of cardiovascular accident. Okay, very nice, all of you, very nice. Now treatment regarding or true regarding treatment of multibacillary leprosy. What is the answer here? Again, a repeat question. Treatment of multibacillary leprosy is, very sorry for this. Treatment for multibacillary leprosy, the correct answer is you have to give 3 drugs in 12 months. Now multibacillary means you should have more than 5 skin lesions. You should have more than 5 skin lesions, more than equals to 2 nerve involvement, and slit skin smear should be positive. Very important. More than 5 skin lesions, more than equals to 2 nerve, and slit skin smear should be positive. All these 3 should be present to label the patient as multibacillary. And you have to give 3 drugs for 12 months in multibacillary, and 3 drugs for 6 months in posibacillary leprosy. Very nice. I'm very sorry for this. Which of the following does not causes urethritis in males? Can you answer this question? Which of the following does not causes urethritis in male? Anyone? Haemophilus ducreyi, Neisseria gonorrhea, Trichomonas or Chlamydia trachomatis? Can you answer this question for me? Anyone can answer this question? Yes, the correct answer is Haemophilus ducreyi. Please remember, Haemophilus ducreyi does not causes any urethritis. I'm very sorry for this. Does not causes any urethritis in the male patient. It is Neisseria gonorrhoeae, Trichomonas vaginalis and Chlamydia which causes this. Okay? So please remember, this is very very important, and I'm very sorry I was shifted to last page. Now can you answer this question, anyone? A female came with a foul-smelling grayish-white discharge on examination. One of these will be seen on microscopy. Very nice, Vishal. Welcome to the class. What is the correct answer? A female came with a foul-smelling grayish-white discharge. On examination, one of these will be seen. Good. So this is a classical case of bacterial vaginosis. Now, how do you know this is bacterial vaginosis? Because there is foul-smelling discharge which is white in color. Both of them is very, very important for making the diagnosis of the bacterial vaginosis. And on microscopy of bacterial vaginosis, you will see presence of clue cells. Very nice, Dr. Kostup. This is nothing but the clue cells which is seen in the patients of bacterial vaginosis. Try to do the next question. Please answer the next question, all of you. Vishal, Kostup. So thank you, Aram, if you like my sessions. Can you answer this question? A child present with a bald patch on the scalp with easily pluckability of the hair. Physician noted black dot on the area. Treatment to be given will be amphotericin B, fluconazole, griseofulvin or cyclopyroxolamine. Very nice. The correct answer here is griseofulvin. This is a case of tinea capitis. Please remember, in tinea capitis, griseofulvin works very well. And you are very right, RM, that the correct answer in the black dot tinea capitis becomes the griseofulvin. You will not give amphotericin, you will not give cyclopyrox, and you will not give azole group. The correct answer becomes option number 3. Very nice. Now, can you answer this question? An alcoholic patient presented with lesion, which is shown here, he also has diarrhea, deficiency of what is associated with it? गुड। वेरी नाइस, वेरी नाइस। द करेक्ट आंसर इज, दिस इज अ क्लासिकल केस ऑफ पेलाग्रा। पेलाग्रा अकर्स बिकॉज ऑफ विटामिन B3 और नायासिन डेफिशिएंसी। सो पेलाग्रा अकर्स बिकॉज ऑफ विटामिन B3 और नायासिन डेफिशिएंसी, एंड ट्रिप्टोफेन is a precursor of niacin. So if there is deficiency of tryptophan, you will see the features similar to that of the pellagra. So the answer becomes option number one. Very nice. Now can you answer this question for me? Anyone can answer this? This is a question from FMG paper. I think 2020 mid-year FMG paper. Himanshu, RM, Dr. Kaustubh, anyone can answer this question? Very nice, Himanshu, very nice. What about other students? Good. Kaustubh, Akanksha, you all are right for this question. Whenever you see a overhanging undermined edges of an ulcer which is present over the neck region, this is a classical case of tuberculoid lymph node, which is also called as scrofuloderma. What happens secondary to the TB of cervical lymph nodes? There is sometimes extension of the disease to the overlying skin, and this will then forms ulceration, which is called as tubercular lymph node or tubercular ulcer. Very easy question. You can easily see the clinical image which presents with the tubercular lymph nodes. Nice. Moving to the next question, which mineral deficiency can lead to the following conditions? Can you answer this question for me? Which mineral deficiency will lead to the following conditions? RM, Akansha, Dr. Kaustubh, zinc, iron, calcium, or vitamin A. Very nice, Akansha, Kaustubh, and RM. This is a classical case of acrodermatitis entropathica. What is acrodermatitis entropathica? It is because of the zinc deficiency. What are the features of acrodermatitis entropathica? You have a mnemonic DDA, dermatitis, which is periorificial, diarrhea, and you have alopecia. Dermatitis, diarrhea, and alopecia, and which mineral deficiency can lead to? The answer becomes the zinc deficiency. Okay? So I think this is clear, nothing difficult here. Now, can you tell me what is the first line treatment for acne comedones? You can see that both open and closed comedones are seen here. What is the first line treatment for acne comedones? This is a repeat question from FMGE paper. Very nice, all of you, very nice. The first line treatment for acne comedone is, yes, you need to do keratolysis, and topical retinoids becomes the treatment of choice. What are the topical retinoids you know of? You have two types, adapalene and tretinoin. And the mechanism of action is keratolysis, so that it will remove the obstruction to the outflow of the sebaceous gland. Now identify the condition shown in the image. Malignant melanoma, basal cell carcinoma, squamous cell carcinoma, or Nevus cell. Can you tell me what is this lady is presenting with? RM, Kaustubh, Akansha. Anyone can answer this question. A very easy question actually. Nothing difficult here. A very, very easy question. Can you answer this? Identify the condition shown in the image. Good, very nice. The correct answer is, this is a classical case of malignant melanoma, and the type is lentigo maligna type. Now, why this is lentigo maligna? Because lentigo maligna is present over the sun exposed part. Sun exposed part in an old individual. So what is it? It occurs over the sun exposed part in the old individual, which is called as lentigo maligna. The another one is superficial spreading. Please remember the superficial spreading type, which looks very similar to the lentigo maligna. It present over the covered part, that is the lower limb or the back. So this is how you can differentiate between these entities, that is the lentigo maligna and the superficial spreading. Now, can you answer this question? Which organism is responsible for erysipelas? Akansha, RF, can you answer this for me? Which organism is responsible for causing erysipelas? Very nice, very nice. So Akansha, you are absolutely right. What about the other students? The correct answer here is option number one. Streptococcus is responsible for causing erysipelas. And what is this sign which is shown here? Million ear sign. Million ear signs give you an idea or differentiate erysipelas from that of cellulitis, which do not extend. It do not extend to the ear. Do not extend up to the ear. Okay? So in erysipelas, there is extension onto the ear. But in cellulitis, because it involves the subcutaneous tissue, it do not involve the ear. Now, cutaneous horn, as shown in the image, is associated with which of the following skin cancers? Can you answer this question? Cutaneous horn, as shown in the image, is associated with which of the following cancer? Squamous cell carcinoma, melanoma, BCC or actinic keratosis? Anyone can answer this question? Akansha, Kostub? Good, very nice. The correct answer, Akansha, you are absolutely right. It is squamous cell carcinoma. Please remember, cutaneous horn is a pre-malignant condition. It is a pre-malignant condition, can lead to development of malignancy, and the type of malignancy which is present here is squamous cell carcinoma. This is very important that the malignancy which occurs is the squamous cell carcinoma. Okay? So please give me a thumbs up if you remember this. This is very, very important for your exam. Now identify the conditions which is shown in the image. Can you identify the condition? Very easy. You might have come across this previously also. Identify the condition shown in the image. Condyloma acuminata, Bowen's disease, condyloma lata or hemorrhoids. What is the correct answer? Very nice, Chirag, RM, Akansha. This is a classical case of condyloma acuminata, which is called as genital warts. Genital warts, which is seen secondary to HPV 6 and 11, is seen very, very frequently in the patients over the genital area. So identify the condition shown in the image. So this is a clear-cut example of condyloma acuminata. Please do the next question for me. The patient suffering from ulcerative colitis present with ulcers on the anterior leg as shown in the image. What is the diagnosis? So please give me a thumbs up. What is the correct answer? Okay, so Akansha is asking how to differentiate between condyloma lata. Please remember, condyloma acuminata is the verrucous lesion like this. While condyloma lata, these are flat and moist lesions like this. Understood, Akansha? So you will have flat and moist lesions in the patients of condyloma lata. And in acuminata, which is a warty condition, you will have warts over the surface. Please give me a thumbs up if you remember this. Okay? And for this question, RM, you are absolutely right. The correct answer is pyoderma gangrenosum. Please remember, pyoderma gangrenosum is the neutrophilic dermatosis, which is associated with ulcerative colitis. It presents with rapidly progressing ulcer. It presents with rapidly progressive ulcers, and which is very painful. So for these patients, you need to give oral steroids to take care of the ulcers which is given here. Now, next question, can you tell me what is the common complication associated with this condition? Anyone? Chirag, RM, Akansha, can you tell me what is the commonest condition associated with this? Very nice, very nice. So Akansha, you are absolutely right. Tahira, you are also right. Chirag is also right. The correct answer of this question, very nice everyone, it is the post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis. So this is a case of non-bullous impetigo. In non-bullous impetigo, the most common cause is streptococcus. And when the streptococcus species M49 causes the impetigo, the most common complication becomes the post-streptococcus glomerulonephritis. Okay? So I hope this is clear to all of you. Nobody is confused. Now, the next question is, a tourist guide in Mount Everest, after one of his trip, developed blisters on the feet. What is not useful for the treatment? So this is a question from FMGE paper. So NBE pattern examination, which is not useful in his treatment? Can you answer anyone? Hyperbaric oxygen, aspirin, phenylephrine or pentoxifilin? Very nice, Akansha, Kostu, very nice all of you, very nice. So after one of his trips, he developed blister. The correct answer of this question is option number 3. So this is a classical case of frostbite. Now this is a classical case of frostbite. Now what happens when a patient is exposed to colder environment, you have vasoconstriction, and because of vasoconstriction there is decreased oxygen supply to the part distal. So for treatment you need to give either oxygen therapy or one of the vasodilatory modality. Phenylephrine is a vasoconstrictor, so you cannot give phenylephrine in the treatment. Pentoxifilin causes vasodilatation, so this can be given. Aspirin inhibits the platelet aggregation and it causes increase in the flow, and hyperbaric oxygen is also used for the treatment. Answer becomes option number 3. Can you answer this question, anyone? A very easy question. Patient present with history of severe burn only a few minutes in the sun, freckling in sun exposed area, dry skin, changes in the skin pigmentation. What is the diagnosis? Xeroderma pigmentosum, Bloom syndrome, wart or melanocytic nevus. Very nice. Whenever you see presence of freckling, plus change in skin texture or pigmentation secondary to photo exposure, it becomes a case of xeroderma pigmentosa, which is a classical example of nucleotide excision repair defect. Okay, so this is an example of nucleotide excision repair defect which presents with freckling, cutaneous malignancies or change in skin texture. Next question is waiting, everyone please answer. Child presents with the sores in the mouth, rash on the hand and feet, what is the causative organism for it? Good, very nice. Anyone else? Kostub, you are right. Akansha, very nice. Yes, the correct answer is hand, foot and mouth disease. Hand, foot and mouth disease, which occurs secondary to Coxsackie A16. In this disease, patient develops marginated or angulated ulcers or vesicles over the lower limb. Okay? Good. Can you answer this question? Child present with fever, pleomorphic rash, what is the diagnosis? Anyone can answer this question. Very nice. Whenever you see pleomorphic rash and vesicles which is giving you appearance which is called as dewdrop on rose petal, this is a classical case of chickenpox. Okay, a classical case of chickenpox. Nothing to explain here, very easy, that this is a classical case of chickenpox. Now the time of reading the patch for allergic contact dermatitis, this is a question from NEET. Question from NEET PG. Okay. So Tahira and Chirag says it is option number two. What about you, Kostu? Akansha says it is option number three. Very nice, Akansha. You are absolutely right. The correct answer here is option number three. Please remember, you remove the patch on day two and you read the patch on day four. This we are talking about the ideal time period, removal on day two and reading on day four. So Akansha, RM and Ali, you three are right for this question. Okay? Moving to the next question. A patient with fever, severe joint pain, she also develops pigmentation of nose. What is the likely diagnosis? Again, a neat PG question. Very nice, Akansha. What about others? Okay. Chirag, Tahira, RM, Kostub. What about you, Kostub? The correct answer of this question is option number two. Now, she is a case of chikungunya fever. Please remember, in chikungunya fever, after the fever or joint pain subsides, or after the fever subsides, these patient develops a characteristic pigmentation over the centrofacial areas, for example, over the nose, bridge of the nose, tip of the nose, over the upper part of the lip. And this sign is called as chik sign, which is seen in the patient of chikungunya fever. Okay, so please remember, this is seen in the patient of chikungunya fever. Very important for your exam. Now, which of the following will show canker redux? This is a very easy question. We have already taken a class on STD. Quickly answer. Anyone wants to answer this question? Anyone? Which of the following will show canker redux? Very nice, Tahira. Ali, RM, Kostub. Anyone wants to answer this? Which of the following will show canker redux? The answer here is option number one. Please remember, canker redux, it is seen in the relapse of syphilis. And what is it? In the latent phase, the patient again start developing the features similar to primary syphilis. And that is called as the canker redux, which is seen in the patients of early relapsing syphilis. Very nice, everyone. I hope everyone have understood. Now, can you answer this question? All of you, please answer this question. A 22-year-old college student with history of intercourse with multiple sexual partners comes with the centrally umbilicated lesions on his genitalia. Scraping from the lesions will show bacilli, inclusion bodies. Very nice. So can you tell me what is the diagnosis here, Akansha? What is the diagnosis in this patient? Anyone can tell me what is the diagnosis? Yes, this is a characteristic example of molluscum contagiosum. And in molluscum contagiosum, you see intracytoplasmic inclusion bodies, which is called as Henderson-Peterson bodies. Okay, so the correct answer is given by Akansha, RM, and Ali. Please mark this that it is a case of inclusion body secondary to molluscum contagiosum. Now, can you answer this question? Anyone can answer this question? Very nice, all of you. Good. And can you tell me, Akansha, what are these bodies called as, which are shown here? What are these bodies called as? Faria, Ali, anyone? Yes. So this is the classical example of chromoblastomycosis. And the picture here is of copper penny bodies, which is also called as medullar bodies, also called as sclerotic bodies. Okay, so you can see here that a patient who presented with cauliflower growth, when they present with these findings, this is a classical case of copper penny bodies. Now arrange the following blisters from superficial to deep? Please answer this question. Which is more superficial and which is deeper? Anyone? Very nice. So please remember, the pemphigus foliaceus, the level of split is subcorneal because it works against desmoglein 1. Pemphigus vulgaris, it is suprabasal. It works against desmoglein 3. Bullous pemphigoid, it is basement membrane zone. It works against the component of hemidesmosome and lamina lucida. And epidermolysis bullosa is also, and it works against the sublamina densa. So the sequence become option number 3, then number 1, then number 2, and then number 4. So the correct answer is option number 4, that is 3, 1, 2, 4. Very nice, RM. Very nice, all of you, Akansha. You all are right for this question. A child present with target lesion on palm and sole, he also has oral mucosal lesion. What is the likely cause here? Can you tell me what is the likely cause in this particular child? Child presents with target lesion on palm and sole, he also have oral mucosal lesion. What is the likely cause? Very nice, Akansha. This is a classical case of erythema multiforme. And why? Because of presence of target lesion. And for erythema multiforme, the characteristic or the classical example is herpes simplex virus infection. Very nice, a very easy question, nothing to explain, a direct straightforward question. Can you answer the next question? Pregnant lady who is having chickenpox comes to you. Adverse reaction of this reaction would be maximum to the fetus at. A pregnant lady who is having chickenpox, adverse reaction to this infection would be maximum to the fetus at. Very nice, all of you. 8 to 14 weeks, 13 to 20, 28 to 37, or 37 to 40. The correct answer here is 13 to 20 week. Please remember, this is very, very important. After this week, the child becomes less infective, or they become, or the mother becomes the less infective. And if at all the infection occurs, the risk of having the infection is better. Okay? So what happens after this? There is formation of the thickening or trophoblastic cells. So this trophoblastic cells will not, easily make this infection to penetrate the fetal circulation. So if the infection will not penetrate properly, so after 20th week, the risk of having infection in the fetus reduces. Understood, RM? I hope this is clear to all of you. So this was the last question of the today's session. I hope you have enjoyed this class, and I welcome all the students. Please go through the repeated sessions. If you like this class, you can give me a thumbs up. You can subscribe to this channel, that is Let's Crack Neet PG. And you can also subscribe to any of my course on an academy with the help of the referral code CHESHTA10. Please don't forget to press the bell icon, and please also watch the sessions which I have taken yesterday, that is my journey from rank 20,000 to 261 and how to prepare the short subjects. So please watch these sessions also, they will be a very, very help to you. So bye bye.